Hello, I'm Sue, and in today's video, I'm going to walk you through the different ways to open your SVG or FCM files in the downloaded version of Canvas Workspace and show you how to save them correctly as an FCM ready for your scan and cut. So let's get into it. So first of all, I just wanted to talk a little bit about the difference between an SVG, which is a scalable vector graphic, and it can be used with any cutting machine, the SVG file, or an FCM. So the FCM is the brother's proprietary format, particularly for the scan and cut. And what your Canvas Workspace will do is bring in an SVG or an FCM file, and it will export it as an FCM. So there's a number of ways, in particular, that you can bring these files in. One is up here on the left in the file menu, and you can import them. So you can import them from your computer. You can import them from your cutting machine. For importing your SVG or FCM, these are the two you need: import from your computer or from your cutting machine, which will bring in obviously an FCM file or a scan file here. Then there is this icon here on the left, which says SVG, import from your computer. And when you click on that, it will open Explorer. And you can see that's the last design I've just worked on. You can open anything you want, really. This one's an FCM. Let's open that and it will bring it in. So the other way to do it as well is through File Explorer again. Now just bring that down. We were in the Pram card. And what you can do is, I'll actually just start this as a new one. We'll put a new page up there so it's a bit clearer. Don't want to save that. So we've got our blank one, make it a little bit bigger. Open File Explorer. And you can see that there are a few choices. One of them will be an SVG. Now, I always name mine, well, I try to name them. That's a good plan, with SVG on the end. But if you hover over your icon, you can see SVG, type SVG. Just saves you trying to work out which one it is. So for example, that one hasn't got, that's a picture of it. This one is a Canvas Workspace Projects file. I'll just say we want this one because that is the SVG. I'll just move it so you can see it better coming in. And what you can do is just drag and drop. So you can see the little plus sign underneath my cursor on there, and drop it and bring it in. Just minimize your Explorer again, and it's brought that file directly in. Really easy. So they are the three ways that are most likely the ways you're going to bring them in, or four ways if you include from your scan and cut, which you can export over to your Canvas Workspace. What happens if you bring in something that's not supported? Let's just go for a new file again. We won't save that because we know what that one is. And in this one, we have, I think that is just a picture file, but I don't think so. Let me just see if I can find a card or something that I've got a picture of. Bring it in, and there's the little plus sign underneath my icon there, underneath my toolbar. And it looks like a cut file. So if you go over the layers panel, so the layers panel is on the right, you'll see the various selections there. Go into the layers, which is the fourth one down, little stack of papers, and you can see that that is an image file. So if you add, just want to add one of the shapes here, just add a square there. You can see that that is a shape file and that is an image file. The shape will cut, let's give it a bit of colour. The shape will cut, the image will not, even though it looks like it might. It kind of looks like it could, doesn't it? To bring an image file in, you'd need to use a trace, and I have got videos on trace, and I'll put a link up the top where you can access the trace. And I'll cover that along. We'll just delete that. And just so you want to save this, I'll just work with this one. If we want to save it as a file that we can send to our machine, we will go export. Ignore that one, that's if you've got the print to cut. Export, transfer, FCM. And it will bring up this box here, which gives you three options. Oh, first one is export FCM. So if we click on that, it will take you to your Explorer location on a PC and wherever you save it on a Mac. It will go to wherever you've saved it last. You can see that's the concertina folder that I had before for that card. So it basically takes you to the last place you were. And you can give it a name. This is where I would potentially put FCM or SVG if you were in a different program, but FCM in this case, because we can't save SVG from Canvas Workspace. And we go save. I'm not going to worry about saving that because I don't need that square. You can, from this one here, you can also save it to a USB. So if your machine does not have Wi-Fi, you can save it to USB and take it to your machine that way. So this is that top one. The next one here is via Wi-Fi. So it transfers via your internet. So this is, you need to have set up your Wi-Fi for your ScanNCut and connected it. And all you do is click on that and it says, yes, I've sent it to your machine and it's ready to download. Go for it, basically. Now this, if you brought in an SVG, your software will convert it to FCM and same, it just follows the same path. And then this one here is transfer FCM file to ScanNCut via a USB cable. So if you've got a laptop or your ScanNCut is very near your desktop, then this, you could use this option. I don't normally use this option. The only time I connect it up is if I'm having some issues with updates or something like that. I don't usually do that. I mostly like the Wi-Fi, but certainly the USB is a great option. Anyway, I hope that has helped you. So recap that quickly. We can drag and drop from Explorer or your desktop even onto your mat and bring your design in that way, your SVG or FCM that way. We can use the SVG icon there. You can go up to File and import it from either your computer or your cutting machine. And then we can save it by exporting, think export, FCM file there. Okay, thanks for joining me and we'll see you in the next lesson. Bye.